This is why you should never stay in sketchy motels. In 2005, a young woman on a solo road trip across the country decided to stop for the night. The first place she sees is the Mountaintop Motel. It looked pretty cheap, but she was tired, so she said good enough. The check-in guy eyed her up and down very uncomfortably and then asked her if she was traveling alone. She ignores the question, pays for her room, and then walks away with the key. When she gets inside her room and sees there are literally cockroaches in her bed, she says nope and decides to sleep in her car in the parking lot. Around 3 a.m., she wakes up to see the check-in guy using his own keys to get into the motel room she was supposed to be in. A few minutes later, he storms out and slams the door and starts walking towards her car. Terrified, she hides under her blanket as the man tries to open her car doors but can't and walks away. She speeds off and calls her friend and asks her to look up the address of Mountaintop Motel so she can give it to police. Her friend's quiet for a second and then just says, "The Mountaintop Motel closed a week ago."
So I used to know this girl who would constantly say things like, "Guys, sorry, I'm so ugly. I just ruined the whole group photo, I'm sorry." And then everyone would automatically comfort her and be like, "No, you're beautiful. You shine." And then she would be like, "No, but thank you." And she would do the same thing over and over again, trying to get everyone's attention. So eventually, I got tired. So the next time she came to me saying, "I'm so ugly," I was like, "You know what? You are." She was like, "What'd you say?" And I was like, "Bitch, if you think you're ugly, I can crop you out of the photo. The fuck do you want me to tell you? I'm not the one who made you look like a woolly mammoth."
Mom would have different guys in and out of the house all the time. Like, we were lucky if a month went by and she was still with the same dude. Which, I mean, I kind of get it because my dad did leave us for a woman that he had started another family with. But at the same time, it was just a whole mess. Anyway, so she had got with this new guy and we're gonna call him Tyler. And by the way, the dudes that she would date, they would literally live at our house. Anyway, so a week after he moved in, I started getting really close to him, which usually never happens. Usually I would try to keep my distance because I knew how wrong it was of her having all these different guys in the house when I'm only 16. Anyways, every time that my mom would go to work, he would invite me to go see a movie and he would...
One thing I could say really pissed me off about working at Bath & Body Works was them damn coupons. I remember one particular customer like it was freaking yesterday. And I remember her because it was my very first day. Why I was on the register on my first day after never being trained, I have no idea. So sis walks up to the register, sunglasses on, all cognito with a hat pulled down, like looking real sus. She places like a couple travel sized items on the counter. I take them, I ring them up. Then she hands me these coupons. She had like two or three, and one of them wasn't scanning. I knew it's my first day, no one fucking trained me. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to say to her. I literally just say, "Your coupon's not scanning, I'm sorry." And I scan it again, and I even type in the little code on the back. Still not scanning. So she looks at me and she's like, "No, go get your manager. I used to work here for 11 years. I know exactly what's on your monitor." Now, the part that I forgot to mention was that my manager told me not to ask her any questions earlier that day because she was not going to train me. Part two coming.
Chelsea is back and she came to me with another life update. And yes, she allows me to share her stories because she knows her life experiences could really help someone out there. So it's been over half a year since her ex cleared out her savings. She's been through many hurdles, but she came a long way, and today she told me she officially moved on and has found someone that she really likes. There's only one problem. He's married. He keeps telling her he'll leave his wife, but we all know how that could end. Chelsea knows it too. He's been with his wife for 8 years now and has been wanting to get a divorce for a while. But the question is, will he? It's hard to let go of something you're used to or comfortable with. Chelsea said that there are no kids involved, which might make things easier, but what if he's just getting her hopes up? She also doesn't want to be the person to break up a marriage. What do you guys think? Has anyone been in this situation? Any advice?
Am I the asshole for throwing wine on my mom at my brother's wedding? My mom and I have always had a difficult relationship. I'm her scapegoat and my brother is her golden child. He can really do no wrong in her eyes. I'm expected to do housework every time I visit while my bro sits around doing nothing. So I don't visit much and I just avoid her. Despite all this, bro and I are still very close and I'm good friends with my sister-in-law. My mom has treated sister-in-law like shit ever since she started dating my brother 5 years ago. My bro and sister-in-law got married in October. They seized the COVID opportunity to have something small, 20 guests total, and it was in their backyard. My mom showed up in a floor-length white dress. Sister-in-law looked like she was going to cry when she saw my mom. So, without thinking, I just grabbed a bottle of red wine.
No!
Uncorked it and dumped the whole thing down my mom's front. Mom flipped out, but couldn't scream at me because there were so many people around. So she just left with my dad and came back wearing a green dress.
Here's a story time of how me and my sisters almost got kidnapped. So my mom and her boyfriend were just going to go out and have a night to themselves, and I was home watching my two little sisters. At the time, I was 13, my two little sisters were 9 and 6. So around 6 p.m., my mom and her boyfriend leave. Me and my sisters just sit down and watch a movie, and then I get up to make them dinner. I get paranoid really easily, and while I was making them dinner, I look out the kitchen window, and I thought I seen somebody in the backyard. I text my mom, and she gets on the cameras that are outside, and she said nobody was out there. I continue making them dinner, we sit down.
Story time about how I was ghosted at my own wedding. When I was 17, I started dating my ex-fiancé. We met through mutual friends at my senior ball. Our personalities instantly clicked and we started dating shortly after. We ended up going to the same community college and transferring to the same university. Shortly after our 5-year anniversary, he proposed to me in Hawaii during a spring break vacation. I was ecstatic and instantly started planning everything. During this time, everything seemed to be going smoothly. I noticed he was working a lot of overtime and we only saw each other on his days off, but I didn't mind because I was busy with my job and planning our wedding. My parents passed away when I was young, so the only close family that was attending our wedding was my brother and sister. My brother was going to give me away, my sister was my maid of honor. The rest of our guests were his family and our friends. People started arriving and everything seemed to be going smoothly. However, an hour before the ceremony, I was told that he couldn't be found anywhere. Obviously, this worried me and everyone started frantically looking for him. I thought to myself that he'd possibly been in an accident or something grave had happened. When I tried calling him, the calls wouldn't go through and the number wasn't in use anymore. I checked his social media pages and all of them were gone. My brother went to our apartment to check for him and when he called me, I felt like my whole world fell apart. He told me that our apartment had been cleaned out of all of his things.
This is a story of the time that I caught my neighbor's mom talking smack about me. So I don't know about you guys, but every single Wednesday in my middle school, we would have a bagel sale. And some people's parents would come in to help out. And my neighbor's mom was one of those parents. And I had a best friend at the time whose mom would also work at the bagel sales. But this best friend of mine, her mom never let us hang out with each other because she felt that I was a bad influence on her. When in reality, it was the complete opposite. She was the one that snuck the boys in her house, if you guys remember that story time, where they peed in a flower.
Story time about how I catfished my boyfriend. I'd been dating my boyfriend Ben for around a year. We were really happy and he even moved in with me in my apartment. Everything was going great and I thought he could be the one. However, one day, my friend Lacey sent me a screenshot of my boyfriend on a dating app. At first, I was hoping that maybe it was an old account. I didn't want to jump to conclusions if it was from before we started dating. The pictures that he had on the account didn't seem to be recent ones. I wanted to ask him about it, and I almost did. But I had to be sure that he wasn't trying to play me. I called my friend Lacey and told her to super like him on the app. She's really pretty and they've never met, so I knew that he would match with her if he was still active on the app. After a few days, nothing happened. He hadn't matched or messaged her. I was so relieved that I even bought him a new jersey I knew he'd been wanting. I felt dumb even questioning his loyalty until I got an update from Lacey a few days later. He had matched with her on the dating app and messaged her. I was so mad I was seeing red. I was so close to going into the next room and going off on him, but I decided that I wanted to get back at him in a different way. I called Lacey and explained to her that I wanted to set him up and asked for her login information on the app, which she gave me. This is when things got interesting.
Story time about why my mom kicked me out when I was 16. So a little background information. This had all started as soon as my dad left my mom and I. I was like 13 around the time. Well, ever since then, my mom would have different guys in and out of the house all the time. Like, we were lucky if a month went by and she was still with the same dude. Which, I mean, I kind of get it because my dad did leave us for a woman that he had started another family with. But at the same time, it was just a whole mess.
Story time, I had to go to jail because of my toxic ex-boyfriend. So a little background information. Him and I started dating right after high school. And this relationship was so fucking toxic. We would literally fight over the dumbest shit. So fast forward 4 years later, the one night he had his friends over and he wanted me to cook steak. I decided to cook chicken instead. And this is what triggered the entire fucking fight. He was saying things like, you never listen to what I say, you can't turn a hoe into a housewife type of shit. So he pretty much blew up and was like trying to kick me out of our house. He went to our master bedroom, started breaking all my shit, throwing it down the stairs, and his friends left me there with his crazy ass. So I tried to get him to stop, but he wouldn't, of course. But then he ended up calling his fucking sister, who is 10 years older than me, trying to get her to come to my house and kick my ass. I never really got in a fight like this, so I decided to call 911. She heard him in the background going crazy like a part two.
I was running through the six with my walls. Yeah. I was running through the six with my wife. You know how that should go.
My family, who is extremely homophobic, ended up kicking me out and replacing me with my best friend. My family is absolutely awful when it comes to topics about the LGBTQ+ community. Literally any mention of it and they get extremely upset. Which sounds like they're suppressing something to me, but I had a friend. friend that we can call Katie, and my family absolutely adored her. Every Christmas, they would buy her presents.
She would spend family movie night with us, and they honestly treated her like she was the favorite daughter.
So one day, I made the decision to come out, and I decided to talk to Katie about it. She was literally so supportive and so respectful that I gained the confidence to talk to my family about it. Bad idea. Hell striked, and they immediately kicked me out of the house. So I found myself on a schedule of switching from couch to couch at different friends' houses. One particular night that was really hard for me, I decided to go visit them. I was missing them and also hopeful that they might accept me back in. And as I approached the house, my best friend was over there. She was playing games and doing family movie night with them, and so I decided to knock on the door. I burst into tears and went off on all of them.
The absolute audacity.
Later, my best friend texted me saying that she had a secret. Follow my Insta.
A dispenser with a pump. Definite must-have for your monomer. And a dampened dish, some KDS glue, some Zebra sanding bands, a 5-in-1 drill bit, some 100 by 180 files, Valentino clear, gel top coat, cuticle oil, and alcohol.
Post a video that made you go viral.
She's giving me a $10 bill, y'all. Look at her nails. Look at her nails, y'all. Look at her nails. Y'all can't even see, but her nails was...
And let me tell you about this ridiculousness. Okay, it's been a long time since I've gotten my nails done. I needed this, but it just didn't pan out the way I wanted it to. Mm-mm. This is what I asked for. This beautiful, immaculate. We're looking at something really great here. This is what I asked for. Guys, this. I wish you'd...
Hope you guys liked this video and found it helpful. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. It does help support us, and let's know what videos you guys want to see.